Students, we will discuss about the different types of scales of temperature. What are the different scales you use to measure temperature? That we will discuss. Common scales of temperature. There are basically three scales we use. That is, degree centigrade is very common, then Fahrenheit and absolute scale. So one is degree centigrade, so basically three scales we'll use: a degree centigrade, Fahrenheit and Kelvin or absolute scale. We'll discuss one by one. Degree centigrade. For any scale, you must have that every instrument has its own limitations and its own least count. For example, in case of a meter scale, it has its own limitation. It, at one stage, you can measure a length of not more than 1 meter, and the least you can measure is 1 mm. If the length you are going to measure is less than 1 mm, you cannot measure with that scale. That is the beyond the scope of that instrument. Generally, degree centigrade, the low temperature, the lowest temperature that you can measure in case of a degree centigrade scale is, there are two fixed points we are using in instruments like thermometer. The lowest point is called ice point, and the higher point is called the steam point. So that between the two, these two points, ice point and steam point, we grade the scale of the thermometer. Now, lowest point is or lower point is ice point. For degree centigrade, we will discuss first. For a degree centigrade, we have the lowest point. Centigrade scale or Celsius, that is also called a Celsius scale. The scale is marked the lowest one and the highest one. The lowest one is 0 and the highest one is 100. So there are markings like this. Suppose this is 50. So there are graduations in the thermometer. So there are around, so the lowest point, I'll write for the first point is the lower point is 0 degree centigrade. Higher point is 100 degree centigrade. There are 100 divisions. Okay, there are total 100 divisions, and each interval, that means between two consecutive lines or graduations, or the gap between any two lines, the interval between interval is every interval gives you 1 degree centigrade. Each interval one degree centigrade. So this is what you have to note in centigrade scale. Okay, this is the ice point, this is the ice point, and this is the steam point. Okay, now we'll see what about the Fahrenheit scale. In Fahrenheit scale, again infrared scale, the lowest point and the highest point. The lowest point is 32, marked at 32, and the highest point is 212. Okay. There are graduations in the scale, Fahrenheit scale. Okay, so 32 is the Fahrenheit, 32 Fahrenheit. So here the lowest point, the lowest reading that you can make is 32, lowest point is at 32 degree Fahrenheit, and the highest point ...212 degree Fahrenheit, and there are total 180 divisions between these two points. So there are total 180 divisions between those lower and higher point. Fourth one is, each interval gives you 1 degree Fahrenheit. Each interval is 1 degree Fahrenheit. So therefore, if you move one graduation up, this is 33 degree Fahrenheit, 34 degree Fahrenheit, like that, you will reach at 212. Okay. Now, in case of the absolute scale, or Kelvin scale, the lower point and the higher points are, here it is 273 Kelvin and it is 373 Kelvin. In fact, it is 273.15, but I am neglecting this 0.15. And how many graduations are there? How many markings are there? There are 100. Okay, so first point is, the lower point is 273 Kelvin, the higher point, the higher point is 373 Kelvin. Now the third point is, there are 100 divisions, just like in Celsius scale, there are 100 divisions in absolute scale. Each division or each interval gives you 1 Kelvin. Now, we also must know how these scales are related to each other. Okay, we will continue with this. Friends, we will discuss that we have discussed so far about the three scales. Celsius scale, that is centigrade scale, absolute scale, and Fahrenheit scales. We know their lower point and higher points and number of divisions and what the intervals of each division means. Now, can we relate with all these three scales? That is the question. So the answer is yes, we can relate the three scales of temperatures as follows. So relations among scales of temperature. Okay, relation among scales of temperature. The temperature in one scale can be converted into temperature in another scale, the equivalent value. Now, how that is done? There is a formula, sorry, that goes like this.
temperature in say degree centigrade minus the lower point that is used in the instrument. In centigrade scale, the lower point is 0, so write 0 divided by the total number of divisions. So total number of divisions in this scale is 100. This is equal to this. So this is same for all the scales. Suppose I want to write about the Fahrenheit, so I write F, temperature in Fahrenheit scale, minus the lower point that I can measure. The lowest temperature that you can measure is 32. Is 32 divided by total divisions, as we have discussed, is 180. Similarly, Kelvin scale, it is this is how they are related. In Kelvin scale, this is the 273 is the lower point that we measure, 100 is the total number of divisions, and here in Fahrenheit scale, the total number of divisions is 180. In centigrade scale, the total number of divisions is 100. So this is how, this is the formula which relates this formula is used to relate any temperature in one scale with any other scales. For example, I'll take one example. If I say 27 degrees centigrade, okay, 30 is in centigrade scale. I ask you how much is this in Kelvin scale. So 27 degrees centigrade is how much Kelvin, or is how much Fahrenheit? That is the question. You have to fill the blanks. Now we can use centigrade with Kelvin. So this centigrade and Kelvin, these two relations will be using. Okay, this value is equal to this value. So I use this and this for this solution. TC minus 0, TC is given as 27 minus 0. In this formula, actually, I am putting the value divided by 100. Is, I want the temperature in Kelvin, I will keep it like that, divided by 100. This 100 cancels. This temperature in Kelvin becomes 27 plus 273, that is 300 Kelvin. So in Kelvin scale, it will be 300. 27 degrees centigrade is 300 Kelvin. Similarly, you can convert that into Fahrenheit scale. We'll see 27 degree centigrade is how much, this is equal to how much degree Fahrenheit. So we'll use that scale, that temperature in centigrade minus 0 divided by 100. This is the formula to use, and you solve it. Then 27 we put here. If you solve this, then this 0 goes. This is 18 comes to here. This is 9/5. 9/5 into 27 is TF minus 32. So temperature in Fahrenheit is 32 plus 9/5 into 27. Whatever you get after solving, whatever you get, that is the answer in degree Fahrenheit. This is the answer. So basically, when you know the formula, this formula. Okay, this is the basic formula to convert one temperature scale to another temperature scale. Okay, thank you.